Morning students, so let us discuss the next part of this chapter, Nelson Mandela, A Long Walk to Freedom. In the previous chapter, we have learned how the inauguration ceremony started. That was the 10th May. Day was clear, bright, shining, and considered as an autumn season, autumn day in the history of South Africa. Dr. Zinani, then the two other men who took as the first deputy president, second deputy president, Swan, then later on coming the turn of Nelson Mandela, who also sworn in as the first black president of South Africa. In his speech, he defined everything. He pledged to uphold the constitution, to follow the rules, and to work for the sake of people, well-being of the people of South Africa. And he defined very, he also remembered his colleagues, his comrades, giving the different examples. Now coming to the next one, the system of apartheid, system. In the last video, in short, I told you what does it mean by the system of apartheid. Before this becoming black president, that's the black people, especially in South Africa, they had gone through this system. They had suffered a lot due to this political system. See, now apartheid, it's a kind of a political system. Listen carefully, a political system which discriminates people, make differences, which discriminates people according to their race, according to their color. He is white, he is black, in this manner. So this kind of the such a system was there, had been existed in those days. So that he defined how the system exploited all the people, his comrades, colleagues who put down their lives, everything, which was based on the race. And it created this system, apartheid, it created a deep or the long such an impact, such a deep and lasting impact or the wounds on the people of South Africa or on his country, and on the people of South Africa, this system, on the minds of the people, especially. So, such kind of the system had been existed that he clearly defined, and the people that they were unable to enjoy their rights, that they were unable to follow, it means to live the life to the fullest for their family, for the society, equality, peace, nothing was there. So this time, Nelson Mandela, that he placed, though before this government, this democratic government, though this system had been existed, apartheid, but now onwards, we are going to give importance that, for example, especially we would try to secure the rights of the people, and the freedom. It means the importance would be given to the rights of the people and the freedom. Each and every man should live his life as per his own way, his own perspectives. Next, and regardless, and the system would not be based on any kind of the discrimination, no political discrimination, no differences, no torture would be there on the basis of color, on the basis of skin, all these things. It means it would be devoid, our government would be devoid of any kind of the things, irrespective of the religion, caste, creed, color. So all these things, or the birth. So that's why that he took the oath. in such he sworn in his oath taking ceremony that he clearly defined all these things and what was the system adopted and how it created a lasting impact wounds on the country and on the people of South Africa, especially on their minds. How the people that they were being tortured, they had been tortured, they had been suffered. How that the growth, prosperity, everything had been stopped, just like animals that we had been treated. So all these things that he clearly described. Coming to the next point, regrets of Mandela and remembrance of freedom fighters. And he also regretted that he remembered. Why did he regret? Because to come to this position or to this moment that they had to lose thousands of lives. It means thousands of people, they sacrificed their lives for the sake of freedom, for the sake of black people, for their well-being or to gain the independence or the freedom from these white people. So that's why that he regrets this kind of the loss which we cannot almost repay, which we cannot feel this loss, which is not in the form of money, in the form of lives. So loss of thousands of people who sacrificed their lives for the sake of South Africa. And he also clearly defined, I am nothing. It means today Nelson Mandela became the first black president. It doesn't mean that he is responsible for this win, for this moment. No, I am not responsible, he said. He clearly defined, I am only the sum, I am only the total, I am only the sum of all those patriots, all those patriots who sacrificed their lives, who put down their lives, laid down their lives for the South Africa, for the sake of people of South Africa. He clearly defined, he did not take the credit. So he is the sum of patriots and he also quotes there. For example, one quote is given that it requires such depth of oppression to create such heights of characters. And he said that, for example, he says that these are the people, for example, Oliver Tambo's, Walter Sisulu, Luthuli, and Yusuf Janus. So these are the few names, but so many other people that they sacrificed, that they it means left, that they are not with us today. Why? Because of the sake of us, because of the sake of South Africa, well-being of the people, that they put down their lives. They were struggled, they took they participated in this battle, and so that's why today that they have reached at such a height. So that's why the quote says that it requires such a depth of operation to create the heights of the characters, right? In our country also, if you today we take the name, today we remember Mahatma Gandhi, today we remember Lokmanya Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bhagat Singh, Chandrasekhar Azad. Why? Because they have sacrificed their family life. Their comfort that they have put aside, that they have not given importance to the money, etc. They gave importance to the nation, to the people, to the society. So that's why today we are free. And they have become, they have gained such position, such a height that they have gained today. And the writer says, Nelson Mandela, to gain such kind of the height or the character, what we need to do, it requires a lot of operation, lot of suffering, the pain. They have to pain, they pained a lot, they suffered a lot through the hands of the Britishers, through the hands of the white people. They suffered a lot. So that's why they have gained this position. They are at this height. Today also they are no more. still we remember them. So that's why the very meaningful quotation they could be asked for the long one, long question. The quotation is, it requires such depth of operation to create such heights of character, right? To create such characters, it requires a lot of suffering, lot of torture, that lot of pain which that they had gone through, right? Next, we have to see the examples are given. These are the examples: Stambul's Walter Sisulu, Yusuf Dadu's Lucchini. So they were the men of extraordinary courage and generosity. And the writer says, these people are really having an extraordinary courage. They left their personal life, their family life, that almost that they threw away. The comfort, the money, each and everything, they did not give importance. So they had the courage to fight. They spent their life behind the bars, behind, it means in the cell, in the prison. They need surrender. For bearing such things, we need such a courage, extraordinary courage, and the generosity for the people. And he also, such a countless reach in our country. And he also said that one quotation, men of such extraordinary courage, generosity that he had used. And in the very next moment, Nelson Mandela says, or he said, our country is rich in the minerals. South Africa is known for the minerals, for the gems, for the diamonds. We are known in the world. South Africa, we found such things in our soil, but our real gem, our real diamonds, these things are not, these materialistic things, this is not our real diamond. So what is the real diamond or the greatest wealth for us? The greatest wealth for us is our people, right? He did not give importance to the minerals, gems, diamonds, or the wealth, etc. What did he say, Nelson Mandela? Our greatest wealth is our people. South African, it means South Africa's people. So in his speech, this autobiography, that he cleared. And courage, a definition is given, that already we have seen. Courage means what, sir? It means it is an extraordinary thing that we have to do. And he also defined the definition of the courage. Courage is not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. Very meaningful definition he has given about the courage. According to Nelson Mandela, courage does not mean the absence of fear. We say that this is what the courageous person, he is a very brave person. It doesn't mean that he does not afraid. Yes, there should be the presence of fear. What Nelson Mandela said about the definition of courage? Courage means, courage is not the, it means, it doesn't mean that the absence of fear. It means, courage means what? To conquer. It means to get the victory over it. Over it means over the fear. Courage does not mean the absence of fear, but what is mean by courage? It means to conquer over it. It means to get victory over the courage, over the fear. So this definition is given here by Nelson Mandela. Further, he is talking about the goodness and the duties of man. Especially later on, he comes to the black and the white people. We cannot have such a definition that it means he did not discriminate here. Black and the white is not the token of humanity. These are not the hallmarks of humanity by which we could consider that it means he is black, he is white, so that's why he is a good human being, that he or he is a bad human being. No, this is not the token of humanity or the goodness and the superiority. He clearly defined, Nelson Mandela. It depends on our actions, it depends on our deeds, it depends the country, atmosphere in the country. So no one, later on he says, no one is born hating of others. And the man who is born, he doesn't born with the hating of others. Later on, somebody teaches him, that he learns. that how to hate, how to despise, how to contemn the people. It means it has been taught, right? It means to hate the other people, it is not possible by birth. This is not inherent quality something. It means we have been taught to hate others. We learn. So in the same manner, the writer says here, actually, the way that we have been taught, it means we learned hate to one another in the same manner that we can be taught to love each other, one another. The way we learn hate to each other, one another, in the same manner, it can be taught, love can be taught to the people, that to love each other. Right? So then the writer says, love comes naturally, opposite to the next idea, hate. Love comes naturally. It doesn't require much effort to teach. So that's why, so love comes naturally. It would be easy for us to teach love. So it can be taught to the people to love, to respect each other. So man's essential, this is what the essential goodness of the man. Man's essential goodness is given. So one more quote is used by the writer here. Man's essential, man's goodness is a flame. Man's goodness is it's a kind of a flame. This is your quality. Goodness is your quality. Humanity is your quality. And it is your flame. So now man's goodness is a flame that can be hidden but never extinguished. That can be hidden or never extinguished. What is the quote? It can be asked in the question. Man's goodness is a flame, right? That can be hidden but never extinguished, never put off. And to prove his statement, he has given the example of one guard. When he had been in prison, when he had been in the prison, Nelson Mandela, when they had been tortured by the guards, by the policemen, by the military men, that time he saw that one of the guards, that he saw the glimmer of goodness in the eyes of one of the guards. At least for one second, at least for few moments, that he felt sympathy for us. He said, Nelson Mandela, when we had been there caged, that time he gave the example of one guard, when we had been being tortured, we had been tortured, beaten mercilessly, that time I saw a glimmer in his eyes, that guard's eyes, at least for a few moments, that he showed the sympathy. So then, later on, the writer says about the two duties. Each and everyone, we have to perform two duties in our life. First duties, this question can be asked for short one. Two duties. Two obligations, two duties. One is for our family. In family, our parents, wife, children, brothers, sisters, everything is coming. This is one duty. One obligation for our family, personal life. And another duty is for our country, its people, society. So these two obligations, two duties everyone needs to perform. So these two obligations. And he also remembered, at our time, before this moment, blacks were not considered as the human being. We had not been allowed any kind of the duties, any kind of the freedom related with the personal life, etc. We were not being considered as the human being. If we raised the voice, definitely we would be tortured. Right? We had been tortured by the whites in this way, that everything had been curtailed. Everything had been almost pressed by the whites people. So this is what few points that we have seen in this second part of this chapter. So last one or two points have left, that we will continue in the next video. Thank you.